Deputy
kept it quiet. You have another one?
Deputy Adams, please.
Making a show of yourselves. Will you please make a show of yourselves? I call Deputy Adams. Thank you.
Where am I? I've got the Concordia. Taoiseach, once again, you have another.
Would you please stay quiet? Thank you. And allow the Deputy to ask his question. There's a time limit on this. Would you please pay the courtesy to the Chair of allowing the Deputy ask his question without interruption? On both sides. Thank you.
Gormagat Concordia. Taoiseach, you have another European crisis summit. And in your interview with today's Irish Times, you spent most of your time explaining why the issues affecting this state will not be raised by you. And that's been your constant mantra before and after every summit you have attended. Yesterday, I asked you, will you bring forward a job stimulus plan to this summit? The answer is no. I asked you, have concrete proposals about how the EU or the structural funds should work? The answer is no. I asked, have you explored how funds from the European Investment Bank could be used in conjunction with the National Pensions Reserve Fund to stimulate growth and jobs? The answer is no. In fact, your position is, and I quote, it is not Ireland that is in focus at this time. And that's your explanation, Taoiseach, for not raising these issues. You also welcome the Van Rompuy report, and that sets out a charter for closer EU integration and a banking, fiscal and political union. And Taoiseach, you must know that this means more coordination in tax policy, even more dilution of Irish sovereignty and stronger EU involvement in state budgets. And Taoiseach, isn't that the real reason why you're not bringing forward your own proposals for growth to get our people back to work? Isn't it because you support these federal EU propositions?
Thank you, Deputy Taoiseach.
Well, you're wrong on all counts, Deputy Adams, as you usually are. This government has repeatedly made the case at European level, politically and at official level, for a need for growth and jobs and a stimulus to drive and encourage movement in the European economies. Thursday's and Friday's meeting will deal with an increase in funding available from the European Investment Bank, and that in turn will leverage up further monies. But it's got to be made available to countries that are in vulnerable positions or countries that are in a programme such as Ireland. That's the first answer. That's a yes. Ireland will articulate that very strongly. Secondly, in respect of the approval of project bonds, an opportunity for flexibility to be shown by Europe in respect of these particular bonds, which at the moment have only applied in respect of huge intercontinental infrastructure developments like motorways, autobahns or railroads. Project bonds would be useful for smaller countries, but flexibility needs to be shown in that regard. And that's an issue that I will articulate along with a number of other smaller countries, that project bonds as part of the growth and jobs stimulus should be flexible enough to cater for smaller countries. And thirdly, in respect of creative ways of using structural funds that remain unspent in countries. This country has spent all of the structural funds allocated to us. For instance, Greece was allocated $16 billion, which it cannot spend because of the requirement to put up monies from a national perspective. So, in an overall sense, Deputy Adams, significant amounts of structural funds will not be spent. And the challenge, if you like, is to find politically a creative way of not withdrawing money from envelopes that are allocated to individual countries, but finding a facility whereby when money will not be spent over a range of countries, that a creative way can be found to do that. For instance, Romania cannot draw down all its structural funds either, and there are a number of other problems there. So in those three areas, in respect of the growth and the jobs agenda, Ireland will be very, very strong in articulating what is in our interest along with the Eurozone interest in that regard. But the problem, Deputy Adams, is the banking crisis, and that's the issue for Friday's meeting. And the see, the problem that we face here is that if you accept the principle of European decision-making and European sharing of liability, the corollary is also true. Because what happened in the previous case, in Ireland's case, where the direction was given from Europe and the government lay down in front of that with the acceptance that the Irish people should shoulder all of that liability. That's where this needs to be changed. And that's the design flaw in the situation that applies within the Eurozone. And as I said in that interview, the Eurozone banking crisis is holding back this country and every other country. As an exporting nation, we need other European economies to be thriving and getting stronger, that they buy our goods. And Europe as a whole buys from other countries around the world. There's a global situation here. So the real opportunity on Friday is for political leadership, and speculators and those who write and comment can say what they like. This has got to be a political process with a political decision to set clarity of structure and strategy that markets and investors can have confidence and understand the strength and the future of the euro and the eurozone. And that's a political problem, Deputy Adams, that has to be dealt with by political leaders. And we will articulate, and I will articulate, on behalf of the Irish government and the Irish people, that argument very strongly. Because what was accepted in the past is the cause of the problem. Principle of acceptance of European decision and European sharing of liability was not applied in the case of this country to our cost.
Thank you. Deputy Adams.
Well, once again, Taoiseach, you've just totally and absolutely ignored the question. And you also engage in extreme revisionism. The fact is you have no...
Without interruption, please. Thank you. Thank you. Without interruption. Without interruption, please. Would you please? Thank you. Thank you.
So what was the question I put to you, Taoiseach? The question I put to you is that you support the Van Rompuy proposals for a federal Europe. You support that. And your rhetoric about, you know, wanting to be the Taoiseach who restores sovereignty is only that. Just like the nonsense from your partners in Labour. The fact is you're not bringing forward proposals for job stimulus. The fact is you're not bringing forward any of the propositions put to you. You know that there needs to be a clear plan for renewal, a clear plan for growth, a clear plan for jobs and investment. Your government doesn't have that. There needs to be a clean-up of the toxic banking debt.
Question, please.
Your government doesn't have that. Before everything... John Cornia, let a hull.
Yeah. Sorry, would you please stop behind the scenes shouting? Thank you. Please put your question, Deputy. There's 1 minute for a supplementary.
Well, the question is this.
Thank you.
We're only after, a month ago, a referendum which was advocated, the austerity treaty, by yourselves and Fianna Fáil. We pointed out at that time that it wouldn't work. Now,
accept? What's the question? Would you please put the question? Thank you.
Would you accept?
Would the usual suspects ever stay quiet just for 2 more minutes? Thank you very much.
Would you accept, Taoiseach, that the people who voted through gritted teeth in favour of that treaty will feel very badly let down by you as you go off once again saying, before you go, you know, imagine this was a Munster final.
Thank you. No, we get the Munster
Ireland
final.
Ireland is not
then
to focus at this time. Sir, why turn up? You're going, Taoiseach, as a spectator instead of a player, and I'm very disappointed in
Thank
that.
Thank you. Taoiseach.
Well, you're wrong again. I reported to the other political leaders on the government's publication of its own action plan for jobs here nationally, as I said, with 270 propositions to open the doors of business. I reported to and discussed with the other leaders the renegotiation of the memorandum of understanding by the government in respect of job opportunities, of taking the lower paid out of a requirement for certain payments and all of that. Plus the fact that I presented a report to the other leaders in respect of small and medium enterprises, how the doors for opportunities could be opened, and I think That's going to be reported on again and responded to by the Commission very shortly. The Van Rompuy report sets out a strategy for greater cohesion, but for the development of the Eurozone and the European Union. And yes, I do support the question. Of creative use for structural funds. I do support the question of flexibility for project bonds suitable for smaller countries, and I do support the leveraging up of extra finance for the European Investment Bank. Expect to meet the head of the European Investment Bank here in the country shortly, because what that's about, Deputy Adams, is the opportunity to provide other monies for infrastructure in this country, be it bundles of schools or primary care centres or other pieces of infrastructure. In that sense, that's not about a federal Europe, which I do not support. But I want to say this to you now. You mentioned the word extreme revisionism. Well, this is a day of particular significance in the country. Particular significance. And for you, extreme revisionism is something that you could be actually open about now, because while we differ here on all of these political issues, there is one thing that I have in common with you. One thing I have in common with you, and that is that neither, and that is in the context of extreme revisionism, neither you nor I were members of the IRA or the IRA Army Council.
Thank you.